in the Buddha leg love, we're just helping the legs open up for this practice. So they're in floating Buddha. Legs are going to be in a wide straddle. He's going to be in chillaxin arms, as long as that's comfortable. And the first thing I'm going to do is just gently rock the legs from side to side, opening them up. So it's not going to be a whole lot of pressure. It's more just inviting this kind of open hips that can be really challenging for people. Now, if I want to push him back more, I'm just going to slide towards center. Now, you don't have to. You can just be really easy about it. But if I wanted to give more, I can extend my legs. Okay, this is a little bit more, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I'm going to walk towards the knees, right? So I can start a little bit lower on the adductors, and I'm going to push towards the knees away. Okay? And then what I can do is actually slide down towards the ankles. I can do one side and then the other side. Them a little bit further away from one another. Cool. If that's comfortable.
That's
right?
The most intense one so
yeah.
far.
That's going to be. And so if I wanted to have him be a little bit more active, he's going to bend this knee and come into a pigeon. Yes. Wrap around and grab for pigeon. Yeah. And then I'm going to just help like a bow and arrow come into like a jackknife. So
yeah.
Just pushing and pulling in this
oh,
space.
You.
I'm doing it, but you can do it too if you wanted. If you wanted to interact. There you go. Just in assisting the body open very gently. Let's switch sides. So pigeon on the opposite side. Just do the pigeon pose first. Let's do one at a time. Yes. And either at the ankle or above the knee. Right above the knee. So I can slide down too and just play with the angles here. Okay? Go ahead and grab just for evenness. Bow and arrow. So I'm pulling them apart like I'm making a wish. And then you're going to bring bottoms of the feet together, both feet, right? So he's going to come into a Baddha Konasana first, where you push the knees open, feet together. Push the knees open with your hands. Yes. And so we're both here. Or you can have the hands back in triangle pose or double diamond. Yeah. There you go. Perfect. Now, I like coming underneath the person a little bit more for this one. So he's going to stay in his double diamond. And now I'm going to come up. He's going to reach around for his flying monkey. Yes. And then he's going to push his hips up. Beautiful. Now, if he's comfortable, I'm going to transition to his sacrum. Right? Reach up higher with your hands. Slide up a little bit higher. Yes. There you go. Well, that's really high.
There
you go.
Okay.
Holding on to the leg loops and not
yeah.
the swing. Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, beautiful. I'm just supporting myself. So this feels really good for some people, maybe not for others. If he wants, he can come on down now. We're going to transition into our namaste. So bring the legs together. Yeah, hands to prayer. Pressing up. Legs together. Pressing up, 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 up. Nice. Beautiful. Let's see if I can reach up and grab here. Does that feel okay?
Yep.
Ankles. Okay, beautiful. Let's spin around just a little. Yes, so now we're going to spin around after namaste. Do a little windmill action. And now he's going to come into star. Arms open. Yeah. Let's see if it feels comfortable to lean back. Not all your weight. You support your weight. Now I'll come into namaste again. Let's go ahead and try it this way. Beautiful. Come on down. Yes. That's wonderful. Now the arms can come up overhead for ladle if you want. Nice. What else have we got there, Lori?
That's it. Them all.
Nice. Squeeze the legs together. Don't spill the gravy. Nice. Yay. So this would be more advanced at the end here. If you want to help get them into an inversion, they can bring their legs wide and around. Reach up, grab for the swing first. Yes, legs go wide and around. And then we can transition back to our peaceful warrior and our inversions from here. Yeah, you can stay holding on if that's comfortable or arms overhead. Yes. And we just did from our chillaxin pose the inversion sequence. So we'll come back and do this one again. Beautiful. Let's go ahead and clasp the hands behind the neck. Get a nice full body stretch. my legs are working, but they're straight and pressing away. So it's more just the dynamics of the pose, the angle of the pose. And then he can reach up and grab for the swing. Nice and easy. Legs wide and around. See if you can land it in your floating Buddha. And we're just going to give you a rock. Yeah. Wide if you can. Yeah. Keep your clothes on. Chillax in arms. Yes. Feel okay?
Yep.
Nice. So yeah, you don't have to transition into an inversion from there. You can end with a little hip love from the floating Buddha pose. Swing can be a little bit higher so you can drop your hips. Yeah. And now arch. Arch. Yes. Beautiful. That's it right there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so in this sequence, we're really wanting to open up the legs. We're really inviting the